recovering from a data attack, recovering from a cyber attack. This is for most of the organizations a big nightmare, and especially organizations that have multiple cloud solutions. And it's not about data recovery as much more. We're here at Commvault, Commvault Shift in London, and I'm here with Goen Ras Armi. He's the head recovery solutions at Commvault. Goen, welcome. I was mentioning already, it's quite a challenge for organizations, and it's not only about data recovery. Can you explain what kind of recovery is required if you have a cyber attack?
If you think about a cloud applications are made up of, first of all, the network foundation on the cloud, you know, VPCs, security groups, and the routing and everything. It's a huge service itself, like multiple sub-services within the networking segment alone. And then if you go on to the application side, they are running on not only virtual machines, but containers, Lambda functions, and whatnot. And the number of services and the breadth of those services are increasing. So in a sense, a cloud application nowadays is made up of almost like 7 to 10 layers, going up to the load balancers and the DNS and so on. Now think about it. Protecting the data means protecting, let's say, the virtual machines and perhaps the data storage or PaaS services like RDS and so on AWS and Cloud SQL or GCP, a SQL Server and so on. Now, if an organization wants to recover all of this, at the end of the day, you are looking at 7 to 10 layers of this complex stack and the size of that. And on top of it, you have logically separated cloud accounts that are like hundreds of them.
Yeah.
Like we see 400 subscriptions on Azure. And GCP, we have like projects dynamically getting created, and the resources are that are dynamically provisioned as well. Now, when you think about recovery, that data storage recovery is just one piece of it.
Yeah.
Of course, we have to protect the data. Of course, we have to protect it properly, long-term, cost-effectively. But when it comes to recovery, you have to recover all of this properly in a guaranteed way, because we are the resiliency provider. We are the last resort after an attack. So we have to guarantee that recovery, and that's what we just...
And it needs to be fast, because every hour basically costs a lot of money, not only reputation, but missed business.
Great. That's why we call it as hyper-fast. Because how do we put a fast rapid? No, it's hyper-fast on a hyperscale.
And it's critical for any organization to survive. Now, if we look AI, AI is used by the cyber attackers. How is AI be used by organizations like Commvault?
So three layers. One is AI in terms of an assistant, like our early assistant, right? To be able to properly protect all the resources. So when Cloud Rewind discovers, it discovers all the resources and it is capturing all the metadata and everything. Second thing is that you have to understand that these configurations do not have anomalies. So when an attack happens, when they come in, they might change certain configurations of a security group, for example, right? And if you notice an anomaly happening on these configurations, we detect them, right? So anomaly detection is very, very key at the secondary. Third is the recovery for AI. Now, when it comes to recovery, as I mentioned, there are so many services and at scale. Pretty much Cloud Rewind, Copilot writes the code, cloud native code, to be able to. And if you combine all of that, if you think about Gen AI applications, if you look at how they are getting deployed on the cloud platforms, those Gen AI applications have so many components, including like S3 buckets being used as a storage for all that large amounts of data, as well as the components of the applications, including Lambda function, DynamoDB, and so on. That really makes up an entire Gen AI, maybe a chatbot. Now, how do you really protect the Gen AI application stack without having all of these pieces? So that's where you can see like four different layers that we understand AI, and pretty much operationally, we are helping at each and every layer of.
Yeah, and then from, let's say, an enterprise perspective, there's quite some challenges. Can you go a little bit deeper into these type of challenges and how to be resilient and become resilient as an enterprise?
First and foremost, understand what you have. As an organization, if you do not protect the resources properly, all the resources that should be protected, should be properly protected. And to do that, you have to first of all discover all these resources that are running your applications. And those applications might be running not only in one account. I mean, we see organizations having 100 plus AWS accounts, like I mentioned, 400 plus Azure subscriptions and so on. Understand all these resources and protect all of them. Not just protect the data, protect the configurations of those resources. So first and foremost, make sure that risk reduces, right? Because without reducing the risk, you cannot be resilient.
And one small wrong configuration, which is not corrected, can still have a huge impact again.
Indeed. And manually tracking those configurations is pretty hard. So the first, so protect them properly. Second, protect them at a much lower RPO. Because what organizations are not understanding is that, and a lot of organizations are getting it, when the ransomware is affecting your infrastructure and applications, it is better to reduce the RPO. The amount of data loss has to be decreased because it could be at any point in time. So you have to decrease the RPO, not only in the local region protection, but also replicating to another account. So how do you really do that? Cloud natively, you can decrease RPO.
Yeah.
Then third, in order to bring the resilience, is about recovery. So it's not about failure. It's about how fast you came back after the failure. That's resilience.
Because it becomes the biggest, let's say, threat for organizations to go bankrupt.
Absolutely. So how fast you come back determines everything about your resilience. So a lot of end user organizations are demanding the business critical running SaaS providers, where is my recovery plan? And that's where Rewind really helps in terms of bringing everything back really, really quick. We call it hyperfast. So hyperfast recovery gives you much better resilience compared to what you might have experienced before.
Goen, thanks a lot.
Absolutely.
All these insights, and everybody needs to understand how important it is to be resilient and to be resilient fast. Thanks for watching here from Commvault Shift in London. Thanks, and see you next time.
Thank you.